In this edition of Minute GarageBand, we're going to show you how to use one of the effects that's available for a real instrument track on a guitar track. When using a real instrument track, you can open the track info pane, choose the Edit tab, and you'll have a choice of four separate effect slots from which you can insert any of your system's built-in effects or effects you may have installed yourself. These effects have simple slider-based user interfaces, like this amp simulation effect. When using a guitar track, however, Apple created an entire graphical user interface that simulates the look and controls of real-world amps and effects. You can still use one of the older style effects, though finding it may not be so obvious. With the guitar track selected, click on the Edit button in the track info pane. This displays the various stomp boxes you have available to you. Click once on the amp to select it and display its input controls. At the top of these controls, notice the small arrow icon. Click this to slide the controls up, revealing the effect controls. From here, you can use the one free effect slot in the center to insert one of the older style effects, such as the AU multiband compressor. And there you go. That's all we have for this episode. We hope you found it useful. And for more, subscribe to our YouTube channel for new Minute GarageBand videos each and every week. So long!